Hello!
Welcome.
It's Andrew.
How are we doing?
This beer that we're about to drink is from Ilkley Brewery, and it's the Longhorn. It's the whiskey-aged Cranberry Milk Stout.
If you remember, the Cranberry Milk Stout, you didn't get much cranberry in it, did you?
Yeah, we actually mentioned that to a few brewers from Ilkley, and they said they were going to add more cranberries into the next batch. To emphasize the cranberry milk stout. Cranberries work really well in stouts. They add more volume, they soften the roast, and they actually accompany well with the chocolate.
Because cranberries do come off like almost sweet but bitter as well.
This was purchased at Beer House in Ossett for £4.30. This is aged in Speyside Oak barrels for 10 months.
Awesome. I love Speyside whiskey.
Kind of had a little rant beforehand, and it went on for about 15 minutes.
Yeah.
So for this beer, we've actually chose a whiskey glass to see if it does give off. So we're using a Jack Daniels whiskey glass. So we're going to see if it helps it. And as before, I think...
Come out still.
Yeah. As it did, it looks like murky. Some parts are actually clear.
Yeah.
Some parts of the back are clear. It's like
That lid's a blob in
there. Yeah. Don't feel Sean.
Just put it all over.
Just put it on my laptop. But yeah, that's freaky, that is.
Mm.
I don't know if it's supposed to glass.
I'm gonna stick this in. It smells like Coca-Cola. Hang on.
Should I drive at all? So I'm gonna have to clean
the
gloves.
There's the whiskey. Not too bad.
I actually do get cranberries. I actually do get cranberries.
Is it the cranberries?
I mean, I didn't get cranberries in the actual oily cow milk stout. And that was kind of disappointing. But I actually do get cranberries. In the bottle anyway. I don't have the bottle. Yeah, it's more nutty chocolate. I think fruit and nut.
Very smooth. The whiskey, you can get that. Because it's the whiskey, Speyside whiskey is always nice and smooth, easy to drink.
Yeah, Speyside basically... It's a whiskey that's been put in the ground, and it's a bit more earthy than normal whiskey.
No, it's Islay whiskey.
Islay whiskey is where it's used peat and stuff like that. Yeah, I mean, it's weird. It reminds me of Smarties. Yeah, it reminds me of Smarties. You know those like, sugar-coated chocolate sweets, Smarties? If you take a big deep smell of it, it instantly makes me think of Smarties. I'm getting hardly any whiskey tones.
Well, I haven't got a whiskey tone either. It's sort of dirty.
It's in the background. Yeah, I get now.
Because with Speyside whiskey, it's not over fragrant. It's sort of like nice and subtle.
Yeah.
So you can go with Speyside whiskey because it's very easy.
It's a little bit smooth as well.
Mm.
You're getting a little bit of cranberry in the background.
Mm.
So I think the cranberries works really well on a whiskey.
Maybe even brought the cranberries out even more.
Yeah. We had the rant in the last video is basically we had the World's End and the whiskey kind of overpowered everything.
Yeah, it just went.
And it kind of killed the chipotle, it kind of killed the milk. The chocolate, it killed everything. Whereas this has actually worked well with the cranberries, and it's actually brought more of the cranberries out of the batch than...
Yeah, you're right. Because what I know from Speyside whiskey is that it's more sessionable, easier to drink, and it's a softer tone of whiskey where you can enjoy. You know what I mean? There's quite a lot of distilleries.
Ah, the whiskey's really strong now. Still reminds me of Smarties for some reason. Still reminds me of Smarties. I think Smarties, that kind of rich milky chocolate and a little bit of sugar coating on the shell, and you get, it just reminds me of Smarties. But that's not a bad thing, because Smarties are a really nice snack. But that's actually really nice. The whiskey only comes out in the flavours for me, over the... Whereas the World's End was more of a rant. This is actually a praise.
It is nice. I like that one.
I think this is the better of the two, in all fairness.
Like you said, the cranberries come out a bit more lush. Sort of the... It enhances the cranberries.
It pairs really well with all the others. So they've gone really well with this batch.
It does feel a bit watery, but then once you taste it, it's sort of like almost like you get that creaminess almost, like a stout, milk stout. But it's not a complete milk stout, you know what I mean? It's
this beer was £4.30. Would I buy this again? Yes.
Yeah.
Simple, yes. Because what it's done... is hit the cranberry, it's hit the milk note, it's hit the chocolate note, it's hit the whiskey note. Every it's like everything on target.
I think the thing is there is that it's based on whiskey, that you do get the flavour of whiskey, but you don't kill the beer.
No. Whereas the World's End,
they used Islay whiskey.
Yeah, and Islay whiskey is a really tricky whiskey.
Yeah.
Because it's a beautiful whiskey, but it kind of kills everything in this.
Yeah.
It's almost like a nuclear bomb. It's like boom.
Because that's I've probably mentioned before in reviews. It's like the whiskies that you should be using is something like Speyside or even bourbons. Because Americans use bourbons, don't they?
Yeah.
Because it's like a sweeter. But for Scottish whiskies, I'd say just stick with either the smoky whiskies or the Speyside whiskies, because that way, I mean, if you want a smoky beer with whiskey taste to it, use a Highland whiskey. But if you want a nice whiskey taste to it, use a Speyside one, because the Speyside are really good. You know what I mean? On the whiskey.
Yeah, I mean, the Speyside whiskies complementary. It's like, you get initial smokiness, and then it brings everything else into the forefront. Mm. Whereas and the whiskey, it's so complex.
Yeah,
it's hard to match it with something. But yeah, I'm really enjoying this Longhorn.
Mm. I think with Islay whiskey, it's a bit of a
purchase the beer house. Also,
Islay whiskey submission on its own.
This
one's really good.
This is real. If you visit beer house, I think they've got a few of them left. Check out beer house, check out Ilkley Brewery. You take care.
Bye.
Bye.